Hello and welcome to follow-up video course Introduction to Flow Mechanics. My name is Matti Ylitalo and I'm your teacher during this course. Today our focus will be on heat transfer, mainly on heat conduction. Very typical case in industry is that we have something hot flowing in our pipe or duct, and we want to prevent the heat loss from that hot fluid to environment, and we add an insulation layer around our pipe or duct. So there will be this pipe wall material, then the insulation layer, and typically some kind of outer surface. In many times it has steel. But this insulation can consist of many layers, not only one. There can be different materials. If we want to calculate the heat loss from this kind of application, we can use so-called Fourier's law, which is saying that the heat loss to environment is heat transfer coefficient times the surface area times the temperature difference between our hot fluid and environment. Typically, material thermal conductivities are quite low. In this picture, we have on y-axis thermal conductivity in watts per meter Kelvin. The scale is from 0 to 500. And we can see that most of the materials are in range from 0 to 100. But there are some commonly used materials like copper and aluminium, which has high thermal conductivity. And if our pipe wall material is, for example, copper, it means that the heat conduction through that wall layer is quite high. Let's take a simple example. We have here a wall which consists of different layers. There is this inner layer, and then this insulation and outer layer. And we want to calculate the heat flux from this room to environment. And we know those materials, so we know thermal conductivities, and we know also those thicknesses of those layers. To calculate this kind of case, we can use the so-called resistance analog. It says that thermal conductivity works like resistance in electrical circuit. And from basic physics, we know that the electric current is voltage divided by resistance. And the Fourier law says that the heat flux through this kind of wall is heat transfer coefficient times the surface area times the temperature difference. And if we now set this heat transfer coefficient times the surface area to be 1 divided by R, we can write that the heat flux is the temperature difference divided by R. And here this R means the sum of those heat resistances. We need to calculate the sum of those heat resistances for this inner layer and this, for this insulation and for this outer layer. And now in our example, the total R is R1 plus R2 plus R3, and for example this R1 is 1 divided by thermal conductivity of this inner layer times the surface area. And typically we use wall dimension 1 meter, so that we will get the heat flux in watts per square meter. Because heat flux is the same through all these layers, we now have possibility to calculate the temperatures between those layers. For example, in this picture we have this T1A, which is the temperature between inner layer and insulation. And we can write this Q1. T1A minus T1 divided by R1, where this R1 is the thickness of this inner layer divided by its thermal conductivity. And similar kind of equations can be written also for Q1 and Q3. And from this we can calculate the temperatures between those layers. Let's take an example. Here we have a wall layer which consists of inner layer, insulation and outer layer. And we have thermal conductivity values and thicknesses of those layers. This inner layer is now having quite high thermal conductivity, typical value for carbon steel. Then we have insulation, not very good, but insulation, and this outer layer here is a typical stainless steel values. And now we can calculate this heat flux as a function of a temperature difference divided by this sum of those heat resistances. R1 is the thickness of the inner layer divided by its thermal conductivity, and R2 is the thickness of insulation divided by insulation thermal conductivity, and R3 is the thickness of the outer layer divided by its thermal conductivity. And we will get the sum of those heat resistances, and then we can calculate the heat flux. It's around 400 watts per square meter. In practice there are also some other heat transfer resistances. We will later learn what means so-called boundary layers and how they affect on heat transfer. But at this point we will just add so-called H values to our heat transfer calculation. We will have H1 at inner side and H2 at outer side. And we can use this resistance analogy also when we have this kind of H values. If we set RH is 1 divided by H, we can add these so-called convective heat transfer resistances to our total heat transfer resistance. Typical values for these H coefficients are in a room conditions around 5 to 25 watts per square meter Kelvin. And in case of a liquid flow in pipe, it's high, you can be up to 150 watts per square meter Kelvin. And in some special cases, like boiling in a pipe, that this H value can be very high, even up to 10,000. If you are working with pipe flow cases, you need to move to cylindrical coordinates. And here is how we can calculate the total heat transfer resistance. You will have this kind of logarithm terms there. And use always radius when you calculate this kind of case. You can add also these H values to calculation of your R value. But let's take an example. I have here a case in which we have pipe inner diameter 199 millimeters and wall thickness 10 millimeter and wall heat conduction 45, which is a typical value for carbon steel. And insulation is 200 millimeter and insulation heat conductivity 0.06 watt per meter Kelvin. And for inner side we have this H value 125 and for outside 10 watts per square meter Kelvin. And we have inner temperature 100 degrees C and at outside we have 0 degrees C. I asked chatGPT to develop a Python code to calculate this case, and using that code I calculated this example, and the heat loss was 35 watts per meter. And if we change the insulation thickness to 0.1 meter, the heat loss will increase to 55 watts per meter. And if the insulation thermal conductivity is 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin instead of this 0.06, the heat loss will be 58 watts per meter. If you need to calculate the heat loss from a spherical tank, you need to move to ball coordinates. Here is some examples and guidelines how to handle this case in ball coordinates. You can also start optimization, for example, utilizing these AI tools. If you know the material price of your insulation and you have the energy price, then you can start finding the optimum thickness for your insulation. Here are some very, very simple examples. There is one more example. In this case we have a room which has a temperature 20 degrees C and outside the room is minus 25 degrees C. And here is a picture which is showing the temperature in our wall layer. Temperature on y-axis and wall thickness on x-axis, and we can see that the temperature is going down to zero in our insulation layer. And you should always be aware in this kind of case that where the temperature is going down to zero, because if you have moisture, that will freeze when temperature is going down to zero. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you again. Bye bye.